In this video, we will do the finite body analysis and learn about heat exchange and entropy change for two incompressible fluids or two solids brought in contact, and will derive the maximum work obtained between two finite bodies at temperature T1 and T2. So we will first find out if we say A, that is when two incompressible fluid or solids mixed, then we will do the heat exchange and entropy change study. Now suppose this is a system and this is a partition, and in this there is fluid, this incompressible fluid. If we say this is subsystem 1, this is subsystem 2, and the walls are adiabatic of the system, and if we suppose this having mass m1 c1 and this temperature t1, and this having mass m2 c2 and this temperature t2, and what happens, the partition is removed and it is allowed to mixed. So let us assume that final temperature will be Tf is equals to final temperature. Now what we will do, we know that Q is equals to delta U plus W. Q is equals to delta U plus W. Now since walls are adiabatic, so Q is equals to 0, and work done beyond the surrounding, work done that crosses the boundary is also 0. Since no work done crosses the boundary, so W will be 0. So delta U is equals to 0. Now delta U for this liquid subsystem 1, when the partition is removed, will be m1 c1 t final minus t1 plus m2 c2 in bracket t final minus t2 is equals to 0. These are the entropy change. This is the u1, this is for this, and this is for this, when they are allowed to mixed. Now t final will be m1 c1 t1 plus m2 c2 t2 upon m1 c1 plus m2 c2. This will be the t final. Now this is equation 1. Now total entropy change for the universe is equals to delta S of system plus delta S of surrounding. Since the walls are adiabatic and no heat passes through the boundary, so this implies delta S universe is equals to delta S of system. Now delta S system is equals to if we do the entropy change for the subsystem 1 after mixing, we are getting, since it is incompressible fluid, so entropy change will be m1 c1 ln tf upon t1, and this is for system 1, and entropy change for system 2 after mixing will be m2 c2 ln Tf upon T2, and this entropy change will be equals to delta S universe. Now we are assuming here M1 is equals to M2 is equals to M, and C1 is equals to C2 is equals to C. We are assuming this condition. So for purpose of driving some important formulae, we are assuming M1 plus M2 is M1 is equals to M2 is equals to M, and C1 is equal to C2 is equals to C. So what we are getting, this implies we are getting Tf is equals to T1 plus T2 divided by 2, from here, because if we put M1 is equals to M and C1 is equal to C in this also, we are getting T1 plus T2 divided by 2. Now delta S system will be MC ln Tf whole square upon T1 T2, and this will be equals to 2 MC ln Tf upon under root me T1 T2. So we are getting this. Now this is for two incompressible fluid now if there are same if there are n number of fluids, we can write delta S system is equals to n times MC upon arithmetic mean of temperature upon geometric mean of all the temperature of the fluids. Because if we see this is for n systems, this have arrived because if we see delta S system for two condition, we are getting delta S is equals to 2 MC ln Tf upon under root me T1 T2 under root. Now Tf is equals to, we are getting T1 plus T2 divided by 2, and this is basically what arithmetic mean of two temperature, T1 plus T2 divided by 2. And if we see downwards, we are if we see the denominator side of this equation, we are getting under root of T1 T2, which is nothing but basically geometric mean of the temperature to liquid temperature T1 into T2. And we are getting here, if there are two fluids, then here it is 2. So using this relation, we can write here delta S of system is equals to n times MC. This is for n number of fluids, and arithmetic mean of all the temperature of all the fluids upon in denominator side, geometric mean of all the fluids. So in general, we can write delta S of system is equals to n times MC into T1 plus T1 plus T2 plus T3 up till Tn divided by n upon, this is under root may n, T1, T2, T3, T4 up till Tn. So either this will you consider, or this formula you can consider. These are the both. So these are the two formulae that we have to remember, and this all the cases, that is Q and W, how this becomes zero, because this type of questions are generally asked in question, and so this must be always remembered. And this is and this all analysis about when two compressible fluids are mixed or solid are mixed. So this is all about two compressible fluids of or solid mixed. Now we will learn about maximum work obtainable from two finite bodies at temperature T1 and T2. In earlier case, what we are doing, we are just bringing in contact two solid bodies and finding out heat exchange and entropy exchange. Now we will brought two solid bodies in contact and try to derive a work from their temperature difference. For that, we know that if there are temperature difference, there will be heat exchange, and from that heat exchange, if there is heat engine, we can deliver a work. So we have delivered here work, and we will try to obtain the maximum work from these two bodies at temperature T1 and T2. So let us start. Now Q is equals to delta U plus W, we know from by first law. Since W is equals to 0, because as no boundary work, so now Q1 is equals to, suppose this heat engine will stop when both have reached the common temperature, and suppose final temperature will be Tf. So the heat lost by this first body is equals to Q1 is equals to M1 C1. If we are taking the magnitude, then Tf minus T1 or M1 C1 T1 minus Tf. We are taking the magnitude basically. And for Q2 is equals to M2 C2 Tf minus T2. We have obtained the Q1 and we have obtained the Q2. Now W is equals to Q1 minus Q2 is equals to M1 C1 T1 minus Tf minus M2 C2 Tf minus T2. This we have this is the work done delivered by this heat engine. Now we have to maximize this work. So we know delta S universe is equals to delta S system plus delta S surrounding. Now since these bodies are not exchanging heat with the surrounding, so delta S will be 0. Since Q exchanging with the surrounding will be 0, so delta S surrounding, so delta S surrounding will be 0, because Q exchange with the surrounding will be 0. So delta S universe will be delta S1 plus delta S2 plus delta S engine. Since heat engine is a cyclic process, reversible process, reversible cycle, and it's a cyclic process, so delta S will also be 0. So we have to find out the delta S for S1 for this body and delta S2 for this body. So delta S universe equals to delta S universe is equals to entropy change for the first body, because these bodies are incompressible. So entropy change will be m1 c1 ln Tf upon T1. This is for the first body, plus for the second body, m2 c2 ln Tf divided by T2. This is the total entropy of total entropy change of the universe. Now entropy is a measure of irreversibility. So larger the irreversibility, larger the entropy change, and smaller will be the work done. So to obtain the maximum work, we have to decrease down the irreversibility. So if we put it 0, if we put the entropy change will be 0, so irreversibility will be 0, and we are getting the maximum work to be maximum. So if we putting this equals to 0, so So assuming, taking again same case, m1 is equals to m2 is equals to m, and c1 is equals to c2 is equals to c. So what we will be getting by this if we putting this in this equation, so we will be getting tf is equals to under root t1 t2. Now putting this value of t1 t2 in this equation, in the equation of work done, so we will be getting work done is equals to if we are putting, then we are getting mc, and this t1 and this t2 will be positive, and this 2tf we are getting t1 plus t2, and this is minus 2tf, so minus 2t1 t2. This is the maximum work. This is the maximum work for two bodies at temperature difference T1. Now suppose if there are n bodies, identical bodies whose mass are equal and specific heat capacity are also equal. So and they are exchanging energy via heat engine. So the TF, the final temperature that is coming here by the entropy change will be TF comes to be under root of n times all the T1 plus T2 plus T3, we are getting TF is equals to under root n T1, T2, T3 up till Tn, and this is equals to geometric mean of all the temperature of all the n bodies. Now by this, and here we are seeing that seeing that this can be written as, if we this equation can also be written as w is equals to 2mc t1 t2 divided by 2 minus t1 t2. So this equation can also be written as like this. So this comes to be arithmetic mean. So for if there are n such identical bodies, so this part will be arithmetic. So this part will be arithmetic mean. So work done will be for n identical bodies, maximum work will be n mc, and it will be am, arithmetic mean of all the temperature, minus gm, geometric mean of all the temperature. Now what we have derived earlier, if we say that case first, and this maximum work obtainable if we are saying case b, so in case a we are getting, in case a we are getting tf is equals to t1 plus t2 divided by 2, and in case b we are getting tf is equals to under root of t1 t2, under root of t1 t2. Now we are seeing that in case first, tf in case a is greater than tf in case b, so we can say that when the two bodies are brought in contact without any delivering of work, the temperature that is obtained will be greater than temperature of the two bodies while delivering a maximum work. So if another case is possible to obtaining a work less than the maximum work, and we are saying that for that temperature is TFC. So so TF will be greater, TFA will be greater than TF. C is greater than TFB. So this relation must be remembered. When the two bodies are brought in contact without any work delivering to the surrounding, so that temperature will be maximum. And temperature and when the two bodies are contact with maximum work delivering to the surrounding with the with using the reversible heat engine, so that TF will be minimum. And the TF for any other heat engine working between two given bodies will be in between the TFA and TFB. So this is all about finite body analysis. Thank you.